Now is this, oh yeah, I got stuck on this limit right here. So we're supposed to show the limit. So somehow we're supposed to turn this. I don't really feel like going back through this again. So let's just say this is true, even though I didn't show you why. I don't have the energy to go through it right now. No, no, I won't.
That was just for
you won't.
Knowledge.
Yeah, exactly. It's in the book. You won't be responsible for the proofs of all the property, all the identities and derivatives that we derive.
Like the natural log proof, we don't need to actually know the whole thing.
Correct. Yeah. So I expect you to know what I put inside the boxes, basically. I don't necessarily circle every definition that I write down, but all the definitions are really important to know too, and all the properties. I try to put all the properties in the boxes. Now, if you go through your textbook, you can see they have these little colorful boxes in there that have, it's pretty much what I write, but it's in color. They have little blue boxes and stuff's in bold and all that. So basically everything that's inside the boxes, if you flip through your chapters, is what you need to either memorize or make sure they get on your cheat sheet. So this is the last page in this section. So we're going to do, I feel like we've done some of these already. Let me make sure. Faces, maybe we haven't. So these do seem familiar, but I think these will all be new. So we'll do a super easy one. The derivative of 3 to the x. You just go to somewhere up here, we compute a derivative. Oh no, we never took the derivative of that, did we? All right, so we're going to use this and find the derivative. I don't think we actually computed the derivative yet. So we're going to use this and find the derivative. So I'm just going to put an a in instead of 3. So I don't have a derivative formula for this, so what I'm going to do is use that definition that I just had on the screen. So this was e to the x times ln a. So that was the definition that we had before. And now just take the derivative of this. So take the x derivative of this. And just remember ln a, that whole entire quantity is a constant right there. So this is all constant. So, any questions on this derivative here?
What happened to the x?
So that first step right there, that's just the definition that I had on the board for about 3 seconds, but it's back in your notes, 2 pages or so.
Okay.
So what is the derivative of e to some function? It's e to that function multiplied by the derivative of that exponent. Now this exponent's a little bit tricky, but it's just x times a number. Derivative x times a number is just the number. So any calculus questions on this? How can I rewrite e to the x ln a? would be a to the x. That's just the definition that we used. Yeah, so at the very top, I didn't write the definition down, but we used it right at the top equality there. So we're just going to rewrite e to the x ln a as a to the x. That's just the definition. So this is the derivative a to the x. So it's itself multiplied by the natural log of a. So it looks really similar to e to the x. There's just a little constant you get out at the very end. So now find the derivative of base 3 to the cosecant of x power. So there's definitely a chain rule in here. And you're going to use that derivative formula right there on the board.